Welcome to today's edition of The Good, The Bad and The Ugly, especially curated from the world of economy and business today. Let's start with the good. Fiscal discipline among states is absolutely essential for India's robust economic growth. And now we have some good news. 13 Indian states have said that their fiscal deficit has come down by 25% in financial year 17-18, from 4.3 lakh crore to 3.2 lakh crore. But there's a catch in this. The discipline has come not by increasing revenue of the state, but by controlling the expenses, the outlay of the states. The current fiscal 18-19 is anyway going well for the states, especially after petroleum prices are high, and so their net tax revenue is also much higher than what they had planned. E-way bill implementation will also improve compliance, and so their revenue is going to be far better. And finally, new products that are going to be brought under the GST will also increase their revenues. Any perceptible improvement in the state finances is not just good for the state but also the nation as a whole. And now the bad. Just when the global trade was on a very strong growth trajectory, US had imposed tariffs on import of steel and aluminium from not just the neighbors but also some of its allies. And now it has imposed a $50 billion tariff on imports from China. China has already imposed $34 billion worth of tariffs on the US, effective the same day that the US tariffs are going to be effective on China, that is July 6th. More tariffs are coming from China. And now US allies as well as its neighbors have said that they are also going to retaliate with their own tariff plans. While all these economies suffer, it's going to be a long wait and watch to see who blinks first. But in the meantime, the world trade will also suffer. This will be a huge setback for global trade because the global trade has not been this robust at above 3% growth ever since the economic crisis of 2008. This is what makes this bad. Now the ugly. Fresh investigation has revealed that Nirav Modi had at least 6 passports issued against his name. 4 of these were inactive, but 2 had been used actively. In one, he has used his full name, in the other, only his first name. This is precisely the reason why he has been able to travel across various countries and across continents, even as India has revoked his passport. It's a criminal offense to own more than one passport, except in the case of diplomats. India has now revoked all the passports and hopefully he should be detained if he tries to move from one country to another now. It is the layers and layers of undisclosed information in the case of fraudster fugitive Nirav Modi that makes this ugly. If you enjoyed watching this content, please subscribe to the Business Today YouTube channel and also like us on Facebook. Our Facebook page, www.facebook.com/businesstoday. Follow Business Today on Twitter India @BT_India and subscribe to our YouTube channel Business Today India.